the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. He who is clothed in light as in a robe was clad in a cloak. He who wraps the heavens in clouds wrapped around himself a towel. He who pours the water into rivers and pools tipped some water into a basin. And he before whom every knee bows in heaven and on earth and under the earth knelt to wash the feet of his disciples. So goes an ancient hymn recited in the 4th century by a bishop in Syria. This song articulates our discomfort with the scene tonight: foot washing. We might be okay with some people holding our feet, a pedicurist perhaps, or nurse, someone whose job it is to take care of feet, someone used to crooked toes, calluses, and bunions. Many of us don't feel so great about the Son of God tenderly holding our feet. We understand Peter's horrified reaction to Jesus. How upside down, how inappropriate for the Son of God to wash feet. Not hand washing, or hair washing, or face washing, but foot washing. In Jesus' day, slaves and servants washed feet. Not the master of the household, and certainly not the master of the universe. This is precisely why Jesus chose to wash feet, to demonstrate his great love for the disciples, the first steps of which is humility. So important was this lesson, Jesus even timed the foot washing to underline his point. The disciples' feet should have been washed when they arrived for dinner, before they even took their place at dinner. But Jesus waited. His act was not to be missed by people jostling with their cloaks or arriving a few minutes late. No, it is while the disciples were still reclining and relaxing in the middle of the meal that Jesus got up and tied the towel around his waist and knelt to wash their feet. No one would miss Jesus humbly kneeling as a servant. We, like Peter, recoil and rebuke, not my feet, not my feet, not you washing my feet. Peter even tried to minimize Jesus' act. He tries to water down his focus on the lowest part of the body by offering his entire body. But Jesus insists. He's demonstrating the nature of who God is. This is a sacred cleaning of the lowest part of ourselves, done out of pure divine love, not by a messenger or an angel, but by the Son of God himself. It's an act so simple, but a lesson so important, it will take him no less than 3 chapters full of words after it to explain it. To explain how to love one another as he has loved us. Kneel and wash feet. It's so simple, yet without his example to imitate later themselves, the disciples would never have understood his death on the cross. Jesus would simply have been another rebel, executed by the corruption of the powers. But Jesus turns that upside down. For in the foot washing, as in the crucifixion, God is glorified, meaning that the cross is the place, is the place where God's presence is best shown in this world, in this time. That Jesus' death is the best revelation of who God is. Unconditional love demonstrated in the gift of none other but himself. We mere mortals will have no greater beatific vision in this life. It is a love that is self-examining, self-denying, self-sacrificial. It is love that washes not just Peter and James's and John's feet, but Judas's feet too. It's love that is embarrassing because we don't want to admit we need it. And worse, it glaringly reflects that we are dependent on God for a gift we are so quick to refuse others. It's love that humbly understands that despite our inevitable sin, Jesus loves us unconditionally. So much that he would show us a way to be like him, to grow in his image. If that doesn't take your breath away and bring you to your knees, I don't know what will. Here in tonight's foot washing is a gift for the awkwardness, the vulnerability, the humility, and the intimacy required of foot washing crucifies our egos, our false selves. Imitating Christ, we are set on the course to love one another as he has loved us. Perhaps Paul said it best. Jesus' actions are foolishness to the world. The mighty Messiah girded himself not with a belt or sword, but a towel. The king of the cosmos knelt to wash feet. The omnipotent one entrusted flawed disciples with his mission. The Almighty loved the world vulnerably, unconditionally, to the end. Why? Because that's who God is.